Hello friends, today we are going to see about eye anatomy and its function. So before entering into the topic, please look into the eye structure, because knowing the eye structure will help us to study the anatomy very easy. Okay, our first part is cornea. Cornea is a clear avascular transparent medium. Avascular means it has no blood vessels, that's why it is called avascular. Transparent medium means a medium which allows light rays to pass through it is called transparent medium. Cornea allows the light rays to pass into our eye, so it is called a transparent medium. Cornea covers the front part of the eye, so it protecting the eye. Total refractive power of our eye is 63 diopter, and the refractive power of cornea is 43 diopter, which is equal to almost 2/3 eye's total power. Next, functions. Cornea is a major refractive medium. It allows light by refraction. Next part is pupil. Pupil is generally black in color. Pupil is located at the center of the eye, and actions of pupil are controlled by muscles of iris. When high intensity of light enters into our eye, our pupil constricts and allows the light rays to fall on it, and when very low intensity of light enters into our eye, our pupil dilates. So it helps to focus correct amount of light on the retina. Next, conjunctiva. Conjunctiva is a vascular membrane. That means it has blood vessels in it. And it is of two types, bulbar and palpebral. Bulbar conjunctiva generally covers the front surface of the eye, and the palpebral conjunctiva covers the inner surface of eyelid. Next, functions of conjunctiva. It helps our eye to maintain in a moisturized state, and it prevents a dry eye. It removes the dust and debris, as well as it protects our eye against microorganisms. It provides nutrition to our eye. Next, uvea. Iris ciliary body choroids makes the uvea. And first, iris. It is the anterior part of uveal tract. Iris has 256 unique characteristics, and our eye color is defined by iris. Iris controls the amount of light rays that enters the eye by opening and closing the pupil. Next, ciliary body and its function. Ciliary body is a circular structure that is attached to the iris. Ciliary body produces aqueous humor, and the ciliary body supply nutrition to the eye. Next part is choroid. Choroid is also a vascular layer. Choroid lies between retina and the sclera. Choroid provides the oxygen nutrition to the outer part of retina. Next part is aqueous humor and its function. Aqueous humor is also a transparent medium, and aqueous humor is produced by ciliary body. Aqueous humor maintains intraocular pressure, as well as it maintains the eye shape. Aqueous humor supply the nutrition to avascular structure of the eye. Lens. Lens is a transparent biconvex crystalline structure. Lens situated between iris and the vitreous. And zonule of Zinn, that is a series of fibers that connect the ciliary body of the eye with the lens. So lens held in a correct place. Lens is a avascular structure. So it derives nutrition from aqueous humor. Next, functions of lens. Lens provides accommodation, and it gives 35% of the refractive power of eye. When light rays enter into our eye, lens changes its shape by the process of accommodation to focus the light on the retina. Next, vitreous and its function. Vitreous is a transparent avascular jelly-like structure that fills the space between the lens and the retina. Vitreous maintains the eye shape. Next, retina. Retina is the innermost layer of eye. Retina located near optic nerve. Retina has photoreceptor cells, rods and cones. Rods is responsible for scotopic vision. That means vision in low illumination. Cones responsible for photopic vision. That means vision in high illumination. That means high intensity of light. Okay. Next, Fovea centralis is a small depression in the macula. Cones predominance in macula, that is the most sensitive part of retina. Next, looking into the functions of retina. When the light rays correctly fall on the retina, retina converts that into neural signals, and these signals are sent to the brain for vision. Our last part is optic nerve and optic disc. The ganglion cell axons form the optic nerve after they leave the eye. Ganglion cells means final output neuron of the retina. Next, optic nerve head is known as optic disc. Optic disc is known as blind spot because there is no cone cells and vision is absent there. Normal cup disc ratio is 1:3. Next, functions of optic nerve. Optic nerve is responsible for normal visual acuity and field of vision. Thanks for watching.